This is the soundtrack of a better world. We are wild. Welcome to the Progressive Birdhouse.
Near the tail end of March already, somehow. And it's good to be back, baby. After a week away, here we are back in the Progressive Birdhouse. Thank you for joining us. I am Bird One of Avian Invasion. And we do, in fact, have new music coming at you in the second hour of this show, so hopefully you'll stick around for a while. I am fresh off the plane from Dallas, Texas. And let me tell you, that was a hell of a show over the weekend. Oh, hey, thank you so much, Origami Griffin, for starting the show out with some bird bubbles, tossing out a gift subscription. Here's a little something for you that is, in fact,
an Avian Invasion original.
Oh, and hopefully it's showing the right album artwork. Oh, good, it is this time. So let's see how many robots we can break in the next, 2 to 7 hours. But it looks like we're going to start off with something else.
All aboard the hype train.
Okay, well, it looks like we are in fact starting out with a hype train, and you guys have pushed it pretty far already. I'm going to wait for it to update. Yes, you've almost broken level one already, it looks like. So, for those of you that are new here, which may or may not be any of you at this rate, anytime a hype train starts on this channel, we start with an engine shot. If we make it past level 3, I'll bring you an original track, and of course, any multiple of level 5 thereafter is a caboose shot. If we make it to level 10, you'll get that pirate song. Ooh. Is the random shot not working right now? Let me see if I can make that happen. If not, some of you know what I've got in the fridge behind me here. And I better get to it quick because you've already made it past level 2. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. My goodness. All right, try her one more time. I just rebooted the Stream Elements bot. Let's see if it'll actually listen in. It's time for you to tell me. Oh my goodness, did we just bust another level? Holy cow. Origami Griffin is tossing out 5 gift subscriptions, pushing us way past that next level. I'm not sure where we are now. Somewhere coming up on it. Ah, there we go. Zero Key Wolf spun it, and it looks like it's going to be the Camelot Mead. So yes, to call a Macro Wolf. That's what we're starting out with here. For some reason, both I and the robot love this stuff. So does the bottle. It doesn't want to give it up. So thank you very much to Pup Casey for tossing this my way. This wonderful, freshly squeezed bee juice. Fermented to just the right level. So cheers to all those of you who made the show in Dallas absolutely stunning and amazing to behold. And cheers to those of you here at home who are going to make it absolutely stunning to behold right here on a Wednesday afternoon. Cheers, my friends. Oh, we're into level 3, about halfway through level 3. With about 4 minutes left on that clock, we'll see if we can make it to another Avian Invasion original. But in the meantime, I'm going to kick it over to, and I know this is fitting, Slam Duck. Here's Weightless for you. Oh, I'm in the middle of a micro dab right now, but I just saw the lights change. What just happened? Some coyote resubscribed and Origami Griffin tossed out yet another one. You just broke level three. That means the next track is going to be another original. Thank you so much for pushing that train so fast. We are just inside the door of level four right now. If we make it two more levels, we'll cap it off with another toast together. So here you go.
An Avian Invasion original.
A little track inspired by a night ride I took through downtown Seattle. Here's a little track called Speedrun. Just about 2 minutes on this hype train, and we have, looks like we've rolled to a stop. Has this train stalled at the beginning of level four? I know it's been a while, but thank you for pushing it this far anyway. Cow Origami Griffin tossed out five more, and Matt C188 cheered 100 bits. That's all it took to push us into the next level. That means we're only one level shy of that engine, or that caboose shot, that first caboose shot. 90% of the way to the go. 90% of the way to go through this level with 4.5 minutes to do it. Thank you so much. We've hit that 2 minute warning once again. Will we make it to the caboose shot? Who knows? I can tell you this, we're making it to some Miss Monique, which is always a good place to be. Just about 60 seconds left in this train. Whoa, and in the middle of it all there, Wildcard 9 tossing out 6 gift subscriptions to push us over. And we are now in that territory.
Hype Train Level 5.
Holy cow, my friends. Thank you so very much within the first few songs. Breaking Level 5 once again. Oh my god, it's good to be back. Just 17 minutes in, it looks like Origami Griffin has spun that wheel. And it looks like we're doing a shot of that hibiscus liqueur. So join me for a toast here on a Wednesday afternoon, my friends. Let's lift our spirits together, shall we? This wonderful swing top bottle provided by Fuzzy Durg. Definitely missed you at the birthday celebration, my friend. An awful lot of hibiscus going in there. I gotta save some of this to add to a Mai Tai later. Because this is definitely an odd thing to toast with. But cheers to you for keeping yourselves warm through these cold winter months. We are now officially in spring, which means the northern hems are gonna get a little warmer, the southern hems starting to get a little colder. But no matter what, we can stay warm together, dancing our asses off 3 days a week. So cheers to you, my friends, for keeping the party going. Oh good, and I'm glad to see the robots are somewhat behaving right now. That's right, if you spend those seeds of awesomeness, you can change the color of the studio lighting in here. And apparently, this week, it even works. And that's 60 seconds left on this hype train in level 6. Once again, thank you guys. I can't believe you do this every single time. And there go the lights once again. Thank you for another hype train pushing it all the way into level 6 right here at the beginning of the show. If you missed your chance to get on board this train, well, I'm definitely going to be spinning for at least 2 hours, probably more, if we make it over that magical 75 mark that Twitch actually cares about. And of course, the second hour is all new music, supported by you and your hype trains, your cheers, your bits, and of course, your love and your attention. Thank you, no one, for resubscribing. You may have missed the train, but I'll give you a ride. Don't worry. Thank you so much, JackalW404, for resubscribing as well. Your support is part of the experience.
Shout, let it all out. These are the things I can do.
Oh my goodness. Basically, starting a one-man hype train, Jackal W404 is not going to be outdone by just resubscribing, but tossing out five more gift subscriptions. Holy schmoly, my friends. Thank you very much for your generosity. Remember, all of these gift subscriptions pay for new music every single week. Legitimately purchased. So thank you for supporting the artists that make all of this wonderful progressive house. Of course, another reminder to all of you, you don't need to spend a dime to make interesting things happen around here. As a matter of fact, you don't need to spend a dime to make the shots happen. Vergeet Poe has apparently had enough of those seeds of awesomeness. You see the little eggs down at the bottom of the chat at avianinvasion.com/live? Well, it takes an awful lot for a random shot, but apparently we're doing another toast here. Vergeet Pose has spun the wheel, and it's going to be the Kyodai Nigori. So if you've got a sake or something else to toast with, grab it now and join me for a little midweek celebration. Yes, I picked this bottle up because it has cranes on it. Don't judge me. I've only been led astray by one thing that has birds on the bottle so far. Looking at you, Falquin.
Osby Scotch.
So here's my question. What are you all toasting with right now? If you're at work, it may just be water or coffee. If you're at home, it could be anything from Gatorade to a fine, fine scotch, not Osby scotch, to this Kyodai unfiltered sake. Well, I'll tell you what, we're going to raise this glass to the wonderful AV crews that make the stage shows happen at the conventions. More often than not, they put more hours in a given weekend than any of the other, like, executive staff or volunteers or anything else. They don't sleep. They have highly, highly qualified jobs, highly technical, skill-filled jobs. I just show up, push buttons, make thumping noises, and scream at y'all. They actually are the talent. So to all those of you who work AV, and make me look good and sound good. Here's to you, my friends. Once again, thank you to Vergeet Poes for spending those seeds of awesomeness on more than just shutting down my wings or making the colors change into pretty things here in the studio.
We'll be right back.
looks like we had two big flashes in a row. I'm going to give IST Alexandria's seeds back to them because literally just did one for Jackal W404. Let's head into some Grum territory, shall we? We'll be right back. All right, so we got a poll going right now in the chat. Is Origami Griffin a cutie? You can check out your options right now at avianinvasion.com/live. And you got 5 minutes to cast your vote. Of course, you might turn this little blue bird absolutely purple if she starts blushing. Looks like we have, in fact, crossed over that 75 mark, which means this show is going to continue on well past 2 hours, as long as we stay up there. Thank you so much for bringing your friends. Looks like the votes are in, and only two of you voted for yes, Origami Griffin is a cutie. The rest of you voted hell yes. 90% of you, in fact. So it is official. We now have it in writing, and it's on the internet. That means it is true. I don't think I'm juggling the corgis. Nice try. Yeah, we could do weighted corgis, but that doesn't change the fact that I have absolutely no peripheral vision. It's, my depth perception is not exactly the best in the world with one big eye. But I can tell you something I do know. Matt Fax is absolutely amazing. This is Boxer's remix of Light On. Oh, hey, thank you so much to Molly Cupcake for tossing in a whole lot of bits. We're just 3 minutes away from the start of the new music hour, and of course, all of those cheers, all of those subscriptions pay for new music every single week. Right, somebody in the chat requested some Bob Moses. I'm not sure if I have any of that in here, but I'll take a look. Of course, that's going to have to wait till the end of the new music hour. And then somebody misconstrued that as, do you have any Bob Ross? And I'm thinking, like, DJ Bob Ross. Okay. That'd be hardcore as shit. And thank you very much to Amanzi Otter for resubscribing at Tier 3. You've been in this little club for 2 straight years now. Oh my god, and tossing out 10 gift subscriptions. Holy shit. All right, we're going to go off script with this one before the new music hour begins. Because that is effectively a one-man hype train. So do me a favor, my weaselly friend. Spin the wheel of shots for me and we'll do a toast to that. Because holy cow, that is an awful lot of gift subscriptions tossed out for no particular reason. I will tell you this, we definitely missed you in Dallas, Texas over the weekend. Not that we had a lot of chance to, you know, hang out or anything. Riley and I usually are trapped behind a table trying to sell shirts and stuff. But it would have been nice to see you on the dance floor, but I hope you're feeling better. I hope you're at least able to get out of bed. So do me a favor, tell me what that shot's gonna be. We'll call it up right here, right now. Oh man, whoever Tiny Text says there actually is a DJ Bob Ross. Well, okay then. Hit random shot, Amanzi.
This is Avian Invasion.
Looks like Amanzi's done it. The Wheel of Shots has been spun, and it's going to be the hibiscus liqueur again. We're going to do a short shot of that one, because that's running out quick. Oh, or you could do the eat the pickle that Bink Magician spun as well. You tell me, Amonzi, what do you want? But we're going to make this happen. You have your choice between this fantastic hibiscus liqueur and, of course, the pickle. Usually y'all send me sakis and meads and wines and interesting liqueurs. That hibiscus sounds tasty. I'm definitely not going to combine the two. But this was your other contender. Yes, these are moonshine pickles sent to me by Fuzzy Derg. And boy, do they count as a shot. But it looks like you want a little hibiscus. So we're going to do a little short shot of this one because I do want to keep some of this around for mixing with later. I might actually take this one out of the rotation after this show because I don't want to murder it entirely on shots. But thank you so very much, not just for resubscribing, but here's to your improving health. And I hope to see you at the next con, or at the very least, the next dance floor if I'm at a club anywhere near you. Cheers, my friend, and thank you so much once again. Oh my goodness. That is absolutely rich. But y'all know what time it is, don't you?
Join Avian Invasion and explore the hottest new sounds in trance, progressive, and more. Every week, the new music hour begins now.
That's right. Not only are we back after a week on the road, well, in the air mostly. Thankfully not tossed into the air by the tornado that actually kind of, you know, took a glance at Dallas while we were there. But we're back with a whole hour of brand new tracks coming at you from Rokaser? Not sure how you pronounce that one. DOD, this track from Komodo. Stereo Underground, Christoph, Movement Machina, POS. Wow, a lot of three-letter acronyms this time around. And one of my personal favorites, Sonny Lax. We got a whole lot of new material coming at you. So thank you for joining us. But before we get too far into this one, the DJ Sessions is shouting out to, it looks like themselves, spent those seeds of awesomeness for a shout out, saying, what's up to the DJ Sessions, and thanks for getting me signed to a management company. I think he means me, saying that. Well, that is in fact correct. Actually, the paperwork has not officially been signed yet. They're still waiting to send out those contracts, but it looks like, thanks to Darren and his non-stop toiling behind the scenes, me and some of his other regular DJs that you might see in the back of that party truck here in downtown Seattle, or gracing the stage at Aura, actually have a booking agent. That's right. More details on that will come as soon as it's actually factually on paper official. So join me at avianinvasion.com/join and I'll send out the good news via email as soon as the ink is dry. Looks like Andrew Connix has returned from her errands. Just in time for a little Jerome Ismael. Remixing Stereo Underground. Flashes. Here's a little taste of what you missed, by the way. Got something brand new from Etonica here called No Excuses. It looks like that poll has finally ended. Who is cuter, Androconix or Origami Griffin? It looks like most of you decided that it doesn't matter. They're both cuter than I am. Actual facts. Well, it looks like we have a newcomer called Show Not Found. Thank you so much for joining us. I'll have to give my thanks to Pet when I see him next, and I guarantee you I will see him next at the sushi bar, because I'm pretty sure he pays rent there now. And other thanks, of course, to Matt C188 here in the chat. I think they're still around here in the chat, but they bought one of those Plurb shirts right near the beginning of the show, and forgot to mention that. So thank you so much. If you guys want one of your own Plurb shirts, by the way, just head to avianinvasion.com/merch. You'll look pretty. You'll support me and my music. And, of course, you'll keep Andrew Connix busy because she makes all of my merch. But now it's time for one of the ones I was looking forward to. One of the first acts I saw upon moving here to the Emerald City of Seattle was Sonny Lax, and this is his new track, The Light. over to Meyer now with a brand new track called Retroville, which I guess is kind of where we all grew up, in a manner of speaking. We're about halfway through, just a little shy of halfway through the New Music Hour, and thank you once again for joining me. Thank you for bringing your friends and keeping those numbers up. I cannot believe how much it's been snowballing since the beginning of the year here. I might actually make Twitch partner before my feathers turn gray. I think I'm gonna do another poll shortly after this one goes up. But here's a brand new track for you called Let You Go. You know, if we weren't in the middle of the New Music Hour, I'd follow this immediately with Houseman's Let Me Go, but you know, we got new tracks to spin. So why not? It's poll time. And good luck, Andraconics. May your studio not be full of smoke when you restart. Alright, here it goes. It's poll time once again. Time to decide what this artist's name actually stands for. And yes, Eagle Beagle, for the record, I know that POS is actually Pavo's initials. Pavo from Above and Beyond, that is. What a great track. It's a little short, but God, I love his style so much. So cast your votes now at avianinvasion.com/live. You got about 3.5 minutes. But we got at least another 25 here in the new music hour. And after that beautiful track, we're kicking it over to Movement Machina with Lay With Me. And once again, if we weren't in the middle of the new music hour, I'd follow this with Stay With Me. My God, this show could write itself. But hey, I'm committed to bringing you the new stuff, the good stuff.
This is Avian Invasion. We'll be right back.
And that poll is now ended. It looks like some of you know that it means point of sale. A couple of you know that it means piece of shit. I guess some of you run your own businesses. And honestly, either of those could apply. But the overwhelming majority of you think POS stands for Play Osprey Songs. Well, if we get another hype train and it goes past level 3, that'll happen. Thank y'all for casting your votes. Like before we continue with the new music hour, two magical things have happened. All for free, I might add, just for paying attention week after week. Amonzi Otter wanted an original track anyway. Well, I guess that can happen. And I think I'm going to bring you something off of the new album I am still working on. Still got to go back and forth with my mastering engineer. Because there's a few parts of the mix I am not happy with, and I've made a bunch of technical errors sending it to him already, so there's going to be some back and forth, but it will come out this year. I swear to God it will. So for Amonzi Otter, here's a little track I dropped in your absence in Dallas over the weekend. This is We Are One.
An Avian Invasion original.
But in addition to that, it looks like Uksevi spent a whole lot of Seeds of Awesomeness for another random shot. All right, let's do this, my friends. They already spun the wheel, and it comes out to be the Hoshi. So it's time for another toast. Give me a minute to rustle up that bottle, and we'll see who we're toasting to next. If you have any suggestions, let me know here in the chat. Beautiful, beautiful filtered sake coming at you from Hollister, California. So a toast, my friends, for we are all different. We're all a little weird to someone out there. And yet we are all made of stardust. So always remember, we are one.
We are not the same. But we are not that different. We are not afraid. We are one. We are one. We are one.
We are one.
We are not the same, but we are not that different. We are not afraid, for we are one. We are one.
Very much thank you to Inkblitz for resubscribing. Stick around for a solid 32 months. My God, you're coming up on 3 years of subscribing here. I will let you in on a little secret. I am working in what little spare time I have to try and make it so those of you who have Twitch subscriptions can actually access some of the music I'm working on and releasing outside of Discord. Gonna see if I can replace Patreon sooner or later. Oh, and thank you, Vergeet Pose, for tossing out 5 gift subscriptions as well, my friend. We're gonna kick it back into New Music Hour time with Saints and Sinners from Christoph. Going a little dark here. Uh-oh, and it looks like Uksevi tossed out a gift subscription. No one tossed out 5. And Kagato75 tossed out 5. We've just skyrocketed all the way past level 3 already. So it's time for another engine shot. For those of you that are new here, anytime a hype train starts on this channel, we start with an engine shot. Those corgis are never going to make it back up here. If we make it past level 3, which you all did right at the very frickin' beginning. Matter of fact, we're into level 5 right now. Holy cow. Anytime a train starts, we start with that engine shot. If we make it past level 3, I play an original track for you, and any multiple of level 5 thereafter, there's a caboose shot waiting for you. If we make it past level 10, I'll even play that stinking pirate song. To call a Macrowolf, spun the wheel, and the next shot is going to be the hibiscus liqueur again, but you know what? Let's do something else, shall we? Do me a favor and spin that wheel one more time. Holy cow, JackalW404 just tossed out 5 gift subscriptions. I'm not sure where that puts us. We're more than halfway through. Oh boy. It's catching up slowly, but there it is.
Hype Train level 5.
Alrighty, my friends. I need 2, count them, 2 shots that I can rack up here. Looks like it's going to be Bird's Choice. And in the middle of that, Rock Pup tossed 69.69. Nice. Into that tip jar, helping me buy a new computer for the studio here. All right, so it looks like the Camelot Mead and Bird's Choice, and we're in level 6 with 4.5 minutes, and that only took a matter of seconds to get there. So let's do this, shall we? Here's the engine. Here's the caboose. Time to lay him down. Alrighty, we're gonna do this as a double shot from Pup Casey here. The Camelot Mead comes up a lot, but so far that brand new Taiku Junmai has only come up once or twice. So there's your caboose, and here's your engine. Ooh. Crystal clear, these two, but there's a little bit of residue. So thank you guys so very much for the bullet train. Holy shit. So for the engine shot, cheers to you, my friends, for that unbelievable blast of support just in a few seconds. I don't know if we're making it to that pirate song. I hope not. But you pushed it into level 6 before I could even get the plastic cover, the spit shield, onto the decks here. So thank you so very much for believing in a little bird in his little apple crate with too many lights somewhere in Seattle, Washington. Cheers. And of course, on the back end, Pup Casey's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Camelot Mead. Thank you so very much, my friend. Who should we toast to with this one? Let's see here. Let's toast to those of you who are keeping your mindset optimistic, even though we're staring down the barrel of yet another recession, tons of layoffs. There's always something to feel grim about. But we can all share good music together, and if that gives you even the slightest glimmer of hope, if that gives you the slightest spark of creativity or inspiration, I encourage you to pass it on to somebody who might need their fire rekindled. So cheers to you for keeping the light glowing year after year. I'm also not sure how deep the tip jar has gone. Oh, or where the tip jar has gone, for that matter. Let's bring you back up. Holy cow, we are still in level 6 with this hype train. I'll look at the tip jar later. Less than a minute left and we're 35% of the way into it. It's time for me to find an original track while this one kind of plays itself out here. What just happened here? Did we just bust level 6? Kagato 75 tossed out 5 gift subscriptions. Spider Man's tossed out 2, and that pushed us over the edge. The hype train rolls on. We're into level 7. Holy cow! So here's one that I almost never play on this show, and I'm not entirely sure why. My earlier stuff I'm a little hesitant to bust out, but this is one of the first tracks I released when I first landed upon this glorious blue marble you guys call Earth. This one's dedicated to my partner in crime, Andraconics. This is Mad Science.
An Avian Invasion original.
So with 3.5 minutes left in this hype train, oh my god, I cannot believe how fast that went too. The double shot back to back. Thank god there wasn't a random shot in there with it. seconds left and we're a quarter of the way through level 7. Thank you once again. We have laid so many miles of track, we could actually create a train line all the way to the moon at this point. Kagano 75 tossed out 10 gift subscriptions, resetting that clock to 4.5 minutes now. We're in level 8! Level 8 with reverb. We are getting dangerously close to that pirate song. Holy cow, Vergeet Poe tossing out 5. You guys are doling them out in, like, huge bombardments here. That pushes us up 2/3 of the way through level 8 now. I should keep those shot glasses handy at this point. I mean, unless one of them's going to be a pickle. There's always the pickle. So once again, that was Mad Science from yours truly. You can't see the track name under the hype train level right now. But if you want to know what I'm spinning, you can always head to avianinvasion.com/Spotify. Shortly after the show is done, I post the entire set list to Spotify as a playlist. But we got to kick it back into the new music hour right now with Rokazers or Rokazers. I'm not sure. This is Leo. Oh man, ignore that garbage transition. Hopefully you guys have had as many shots as I have at this point. 2 minutes on this train.
This is Avian Invasion.
And that's a 60-second warning. We're 2/3 of the way through level 8. The train might roll into the station here, and that is absolutely acceptable. Believe me, I never, to this day, I cannot believe how frequently you guys push those trains past level 5. Nobody else on Twitch has a crowd like you guys. You buoy my spirits, you keep me in business, and you keep the music flowing. And apparently the sake and the mead as well. Uh-oh. Uksevi tossed out five more, and that pushes us now into level 9, and oh my god, Kagato 75 just tossed out 10 more! That's gonna put us deep into level 9 territory. The clock is reset with another 5 minutes. Yeah, we're now 3/4 of the way through level 9, which means you have 125% more to go till another shot and me singing the yo-ho-ho song. I cannot believe this. Holy shit. Oh my god, it's a level 9 hype train. I will tell you right now, this show is gonna run long today. That is for sure. We're already past the 2-hour mark. So many bird bubbles, it is never gonna stop! Another 5. Howlwind tossed out 5 here. Inkblitz tossed out 3. That kills level 9. We're now into level 10. If you beat this one, then I have to sing that stinking song. I mean that glorious piece of progressive house weirdness. The Last Pirate. Oh my god, that puts us 1/4 of the way through level 10. Holy schmoly. We'll see where this goes, but the clock is reset. There's 4:20 on the clock. We're now kicking it over to DOD with something a little housier than I usually play. This is Set Me Free. Let's see if this kicks it up a notch. This train seems to be rolling downhill and picking up speed. My God, man.
Set me free! I'm
Holy cow, with another 5 gift subscriptions at the 2-minute mark, Kagato 75 seems to be pushing this train, gotten out of the train, gotten behind the caboose, and is just shoving it bodily up the hill. It gets a little steeper at this point, but you got about 90 seconds, and you're halfway through level 10. If we make it to the end, then I got to find a way to make it to E flat. Oh, sorry, got to find a way to make it to E. See if we can make it happen. Oh my god, Unifor 20 with another 5 that pushes us up to 84. 60 seconds left, and you've only got 16% more of this level to go till another shot or a pickle. Oh my god. Zero Key Wolf tossing one out, and Wild Card 9 tossing another one out there. I know the number's not correct, but I'm going to hit the button anyway.
Hype Train level 5.
All right, my friends, it looks like we're doing this. You made it into level 11. Holy shit. That means it's time for a shot. Now, do you want to spin the wheel or do you want the pickle? It looks like Tacala Mackerwolf is voting for the pickle here. This train is absolutely out of control. We're just sort of laying our own track and going right through the streets. We're heading downtown with this one. I got another vote for Pirate Pickle here. Ciela says, and someone give this bird a pickle, he clearly wants one. You know what? We're going to make this a double shot. Why not? Well, this is going to be a weird one, that's for sure. So huge thank you, guys. Oh my goodness. I mean, that does reset the clock to another 5 minutes. But I guess we're doing this as our level 10 caboose shot. And I'm also going to do this. Because why not? We're going to do a shot of this moonshine pickle juice here. So thank you so much to all those of you who have been pushing this hype train. It looked like it was going to get stuck on that final hill, but all of you got out and back, dug your heels in, and shoved this sucker up the hill. So it's time for a moonshine pickle, courtesy of Fuzzy Derg here in the chat. Cheers to you, my friends. Stay weird. Buddha T is asking if that's pickle juice. Kinda. This is moonshine in here. Now, it's not like 130 proof moonshine. That we reserve for if we make it past $1,000 mark on the tip jar goal. Because that's basically a stream ender. But cheers to you guys. Oh my god, these are so good. Oh yes. And to chase it, a little bit of that sweet briny moonshine. This is one of the oddest things I've ever done on this show. Thank you, Fuzzy Dirk, for finding the weirdest shit for these engine and caboose shots. So thank you guys so much. I don't even know what to toast to anymore. We've done so many toasts. So here's to the weird ones. Here's to those who have found community, even if you're outcasts. I love you all so very much, and I cannot believe your generosity continues week after week. Cheers, my friends. Oh, yeah. It's like me, salty and alcoholic. But of course, since we busted past level 11... you know what time it is. There's still a minute and a half left on this train. I have my doubts we're making it to another caboose shot. But we have definitely made it into this territory. A little throwback from my years when I was just a human. Here you are, my friends. They say a pirate's life for me, but pirates of what century? Are there corsairs and sailing ships, or torrent trading little ships on P2P or the high seas? Will there be blood or C&Ds? 30 seconds left. Oh, looks like 20 now. Don't make Anonymous upset. Thank God I haven't crossed them yet. Are they peg-legged with parrot pets? Or basement rats afraid of sex? Somewhere I think they missed a step, 'cause they don't look like Johnny Depp. And down it goes, that train has rolled to a stop in the middle of level 11. Yo ho ho, is there nowhere left to go? And the booty calls, does anybody know? Yo ho, sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting with the MPA. Yo ho, is there nowhere left to go? And the booty calls, does anybody show? Yo ho, sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting with the RIAA. Will nothing stop them in their tracks? God knows they've tried to patch their cracks. With DRM they can't decrypt. Maybe a disc that can't be ripped. There's blood on everybody's hands. Oh shit, I think we killed the fans. Yo ho ho, is there nowhere left to go? And the booty calls, does anybody know? Yo ho, sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting with the MPAA. Yo ho, is there nowhere left to go? And the booty calls, does anybody show? Yo ho, sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting with the USA. Yo ho ho, is there nowhere left to go? And the booty calls, does anybody know? Yo ho, sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting with the MPAA. Yo ho, is there nowhere left to go? When the booty calls, does anybody show? Sail away, set a course for Pirate Bay, 'cause the last pirate's fighting, the last pirate's fighting, the last pirate's fighting with the RIAA. So holy stonking hell, you guys just pushed one of the most amazing hype trains I've ever seen. In the middle of it, there were tips as well. Getting me all the way up to almost $600 towards a new Mac here in the studio. And of course, definitely paying for all of these wonderful, wonderful tracks. My God, it's absolutely amazing. Thank you to Zero Key Wolf, Wildcard 9, Unifor20, Kagato 75, Silent Dawn Tiger, Howlwind, Ink Blitz, Ooksevi, Vergeet Pose, Spider-Man, Rock Pup, Jackal W404, Amonzi Otter, no one. Oh my goodness. I think that's about it. For tossing out so bloody many gift subscriptions, there isn't a soul left on Twitch who isn't a part of the invasion at this point, whether they know it or not. Thank you so much. The show continues. We're out of the new music hour. It's time for a little knockdown with Jerome Isma A. Thank you. I see. Show Not Found is asking, is there a general posted schedule anywhere in here? Yes, there is, right on Twitch. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. This Friday may be the last of the early bird breakfasts, by the way. So if you want to tune in again for something a lot chiller than this show, join me at avianinvasion.com/live at 9 a.m. Pacific time on Friday. Otherwise, it's going to start showing every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 3 p.m. In the middle of all that mayhem, Matt C188 wanted an original track, so here you got it.
An Avian Invasion original.
Holy shit, there's a lot of corgis to put back on here. Was the title track off of my Procedural Generation EP, and if you want to find that one, you can go to avianinvasion.com/procedural. But in the meantime, we're kicking it into the third hour now, and by the third hour, I mean we're already halfway through the third hour. Time for a little hide and seek with Rafaela and Night Laps. At this point, I have a veritable corgi ranch sat on top of the decks here. It's kind of nuts. I see Show Not Found is saying, I have to say, looking at how polished your stream is, how many folks are here, I am shocked at the lack of partner status. Well, so am I. I figured given the size of the crowd and how unbelievably exuberant they are and how easily they seem to throw out gift subscriptions to people they don't even know, I guess Twitch wants more. Well, now that I'm back from Dallas and I've got a bit of time before my next stage gig, we're going to make a serious, serious push, not just for more corgis. We are going to make a serious push for partner. That's part of the reason I'm bringing the early bird out of the rotation and pushing a deep house set on Fridays. Tell me something. What should I call it? Not going to make a poll for this one, but a deep house set Friday evenings. We'll be right back. I have to admit, y'all, I kind of have the pickle burps now. No regrets, because they are kind of fucking awesome and they taste wonderful. I wish I could put that in my hospitality rider. Alcoholic pickles backstage, if you please. But forget the pickle burps. It's time for the tin licks. Getting back from a convention gig is always, it's a bit taxing on the system. You're staying up late all night, we're standing behind a merch table all day long. And through it all, we're expected to party and throw on a good show, too. Yeah. So sometimes I feel like a sleepwalker. Holy cow, we got over 100 viewers now. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and bringing your friends with you. You warm my heart and all of the various circuits between that and my brain. Hey, Crimson 5, 6, 7, 8. My Roman numerals are not great. Crimson 8 found a brand new little thing you can spend those seeds of awesomeness on. I'll show you in just a minute. Time to kick it over to some other birds, but still tin liquor. So a huge thank you to Scott Pittman, who was paying attention a little while ago on one of the streams where, for some reason, we ended up singing the praises of the great and mighty Stroop Waffles. And they sent me a friggin' 40-pack of them. So it's snack time here, and I get to open a new bag. Oh, yes. It's a Dutch delight that normally goes with your morning coffee. But apparently, they're good for a long after pickle chaser. Oh, yes, Big Magician. There are Stroop Waffles here. You see, a lot of Twitch streamers have, like, you know, give the cat a treat, give the dog a treat. No, this one's give the bird a treat, and in this case, he's going to drop it on his studio floor. Let's stroop, shall we? Oh, yeah. God, they're just tiny like candy waffles. Why are they so good? Why are they so good? What Dutch magic is this? God, somebody's suggesting Stroopwafel tiramisu, and I want. We'll be right back. Oh my God, now somebody's suggesting Stroopwafel baklava. I just had one of these and you are killing me. Thankfully, there is in fact a hard stop to this show. Normally I just run until I drop, but y'all have half an hour left, which means it's time to figure out who you want me to raid come 6:30. I know it's been over a week since we've been together, but I do have to stop at a very specific time on Wednesdays. So tell me, where are we going after this? And of course, keep your options open because the playing field may change between now and the top of the hour, or the half hour. Oh, I see Starry Ott here in the chat is asking, is Moonlight Rendezvous not on Spotify? Not yet. That one's going to be on my next album called Into the Trees, which I'm still working on. As a matter of fact, tomorrow is going to be largely spent remixing some of the tracks and resending them to my mastering engineer, Adi. But hey, if you want to, you can actually grab it right now by heading to avianinvasion.com/Patreon and get it before the album comes out. Some of y'all know that beat. And you know what it means. It's Houseman time. His absolutely outstanding remix of Matt Zo's Problems.
Thank you.
You know, one of these days I'm going to get to share the stage with Mr. Hausman, one of the most talented young producers I've ever met, and he is going places. And he's over in Denver, not that far away from the great city of Seattle. Literally any Southwest Airlines flight is likely to head there. That means I can get Smashburger. Ooh. Also, a brief congratulations to everybody here in the stream. This is the first time, actually, the first time that you've gotten all 11 of the tiny corgis up on the deck at the same time. I have no more corg to give. And Timbin with the reset. Thank you so much.
Don't think back to your love. in a different life. What a thing we could have become. Yeah, they say with time my heart won't hurt this bad. But I think they just don't know love like we have. Yeah.
Oh, hey, we got one of the booty corns in the chat. Welcome, Eskimo Bro SP. Eskimo Brosp. Yeah, why not? We'll go with that. The last 15 minutes of this show, 15 minutes or so, I should say, and I want to thank you all once again for several hype trains, one of which made it all the way into frickin' level 11. Holy cow. It's always humbling week after week after week, realizing that in this incredibly difficult business of making thumping noises for a living, you all believe in me. And I'll tell you what, I believe in you. Thank you so much, Smithamore, for tossing out a gift subscription to 25% of the booty corns. Oh, shit, I just saw the lights change. Again, I saw the lights change one more time. You know what that means?
All aboard the hype train.
Oh, boy. All right, so I may be running a little longer than 6:30 today. We'll see what happens. For those of you that are new here, anytime a hype train starts on this channel, we start with an engine shot. If we make it past level 3, I'll bring you another original track. And, of course, any multiple of level 5 thereafter, we take a caboose shot. So spin that wheel, my friends. What is that engine shot gonna be? Looks like Zero Key Wolf spun the wheel of shots, and it's going to be the Mura Mountain. I'll dig that one up. It's time for a toast, my friends. Holy cow, we're already 75% of the way through level 1 on this third hype train in this show. Time for some milky white sake goodness here, the Mura Mountain. Well, thank you very much, Starry Odds. 60 bits, like you say, may not be much, but it is very much appreciated. All of your bits and cheers and subscriptions not only keep all these wonderful lights on, but they pay for all the new music week after week. So thank you so much to you and Kagato for trying to kick it at least past level 1. Cheers, my friends. Oh, there go the lights again. Level 1 just went down. We're starting in on level 2. The clock is reset to about 5 minutes. This may be a longer show than I anticipated, but I think they'll understand upstairs. The tacos can wait. I am simply humbled by this. Holy cow. Tacos can also come downstairs, says to call a macro wolf. That may have to happen if this goes on. Oh my god, once again, Kagato 75 tossing out 5 gift subscriptions. Killing an entire level almost single-handedly. We are starting in on level 3. We make it to the end of this one, I'll bring you another original.
And I believe in you.
Oh, hot damn, Matt C88, 188, giving out one, bringing us to 3/4 of level 3, and we still have more than 4 minutes. In honor of the Stroop Waffle earlier, little breakfast down here in the studio. It's time for Breakfast on Mars from Luttrell, another Seattle person. I was going to say Seattle native, but I'm pretty sure he just moved here about the same time I landed here. And I may have this glorious shiny beak, but I will never be able to grow a mustache like Latrell can. Oh, Unifor 20. Oh, almost kicking it past level 3. 98%. And there we go, Zero Key Wolf with just 100 bits, tossing it over the edge. That is level 3 gone down, my friends. It's time for an original track. Thank you so very much for that. We're into level 4 now. Wildcard 9 is asking if there's anybody left here without a subscription. Nobody's answering. That's just the way it rolls on this show. There may not be anyone left on Twitch without a subscription to this channel, even if they don't know it yet. I mean, I'll tell you right now, Lunia Stream doesn't have the robot doesn't have a subscription, but I don't think they mind. But there's 2 minutes left in this train. We have just entered level 4. Even if it rolls to a stop here, you guys have been incredibly generous this entire show after being gone for more than a week. Kagato again, kicking that train a little further. We're a quarter of the way through level 4 now. And Stariot just got on board. On board, that is. And that's your 60-second warning. Thank you. This train is rolling to a stop in 30 seconds. Seconds in, whether or not it goes any further, you did make it past level 3 already, so it's time for
an Avian Invasion original.
Now this is a track I think I'm going to release sometime in April. Of course, it's already available at avianinvasion.com/patreon. Holy cow! Wildcard 9 tossed out 5 more for the clincher. The clock is reset. We're now into level 5. If you make it past this one, it's time for another caboose shot. In the meantime, have a little Mad Hatter right here in the Progressive Birdhouse. Holy cow. We're already a quarter of the way through level 5. Holy cow. Let's see if a little keytar can add some fuel to this train. Once again, we're at that 60-second mark with just 40% more to go to bust level 5 and cap this show off with one more caboose shot. I'm going to be running a little bit longer than 6:30. I'm not going to call it quits that easily. Somebody was asking what this track was. Of course, it is covered up by the Hype Train graphic right now, but if you'd like to know what it is I'm spinning and follow all of these songs, add them to your own set lists. You can always join me at avianinvasion.com/Spotify. Holy cow, Wildcard 9 tossing out a whole bunch of gift subscriptions. Uksevi tossing one out. 30 seconds left and there's only 8% left. Oh, it's coming down to the wire. Oh, there we go. Uksevi tossing one out in Unifor 20 as well. That pushes us over the edge.
Hype Train, level 5.
Holy cow, you guys. I cannot thank you enough for this. That's a third Hype Train making it past level 5. Somebody do me a favor and spin that wheel, and we'll do another toast here. Of course, the clock is reset to 5 minutes once again. Oh my god, we're already more than a third of the way through level 6. What are we toasting with now, my friends? Ah, sorry, Unifor 20, but Ciala beat you to it. It's gonna be another pickle. Alrighty, for those of you that don't know, Fuzzy Derg here in the chat. Most people have been sending me Sakis, as a matter of fact. I'm going to put that chat command in for you. Most people have been sending me things like sakis and meads and wines for toasts here on the show, but Fuzzy Derg sends me the most bizarre shit. In this case, moonshine pickles. What's the ABV here? Okay, so it's only 40 proof. It's not exactly what you'd call full-on Tennessee moonshine. But we do this one as a double, so. Well, that hype train rolls on at about 34% through level 5. We toast first to those of you who are new here and did not expect this shit when tuning into some DJ on Twitch. Thank you for sticking around. Thank you for opening your mind. And thank you for being a part of the weirdness that is our lives here on this little blue marble called Earth. Cheers. Oh my goodness. I can't get enough of these, and that's dangerous. Had told me when I first landed on Earth that I would be ending some of my shows with a shot of alcoholic pickle juice, I would have said, awesome. Cheers to you, my friends, and thank you so much for being a part of my life. Yes. 2 minutes left on this hype train. We are in level 6, and I'm speechless. Apparently, I'm still going to talk anyway, even though no words are actually making it all the way up here. They're only coming out the beak. Yes, Wildcard 9, I am in fact addicted to the pickles. Normally I grow my own, but we're a little out of season for that here in the Northern Hemisphere. So normally I'd say we're raiding out of here at this point. With just 1 minute left in this hype train, however, it is still going. We're going to run a bit long today. Might even push it all the way to 7 o'clock. So we're going to see what happens.
Avian invasion.
Yes, this train is rolling to a stop. Just 10 seconds remain. I am still stunned. No, sadly, we are not going to stream the taco party. Slash beer tasting. And there it goes, my friends. Level 6. We rolled to a stop inside of level 6. Thank you very much. That is 21 gift subscriptions paired with more than 1,500 bits thrown at me. Thank you for not just supporting me and keeping the lights on and the music flowing. Thank you for not just supporting each other with an ad-free experience here on Twitch, but thank you for supporting the artists, allowing me to purchase all of this music legitimately, week after week after week. Alright, so we're going to roll straight to the top of the hour with this one. Normally I cut it off at 6:30 on tacos and beer night, but, well, people are already starting to arrive. Hopefully they can help with the taco making. They can probably hear me above the studio right now. And we're going to kick it over to some more Matt Facts and Matters with Moves. One of the first tracks I picked up upon landing upon this planet. One of the tracks that made me fall in love with Matt Facts, in fact. Not just because he has a sexy name. That's right, if I ever decide to go DJing out in the woods, I will have a whole stack of Matt Facts in my knapsack. Huh, the pickles must not be that alcoholic. I managed to get that one out without tripping over it. So with that, we only have about 3 minutes left in this show. Actually, just a couple of minutes left. But I want to thank you all so much for turning a two-hour show into a four-hour show. My first time back after more than a week gone. Of course, I will be back at Friday morning at 9 a.m. Pacific time for an exploration of deep and organic house called the Early Bird Breakfast, and I hope you'll join me for that. So somebody in the chat way earlier when we thought we were going to end this show suggested somebody I've never followed nor rated before, and I like it. Houseman is not on, but Man of House is, so we're going to head over there next. Thank you once again for tuning in. I am Bird One of Avian Invasion. Remember, take the light that you may have gathered from this experience and pass it on to somebody who may be stuck in darkness right now. God knows there are plenty who could use a little torch to lead them out of their own darkness. So for now, I have to leave you with the giant robot voice, which hopefully will work. It's time for me to get some beer and tacos, and it's time for y'all to calm down. I'm just kidding. The party continues on the next channel. So thank you very much for being with me for this journey. I'll see you Friday morning at 9 a.m. Pacific time. And until then, I leave you with this.
Thank you for listening. This show only exists because of dedicated patrons like these. If you want to hear more, the invasion needs you at avianinvasion.com/Patreon. Look for Avian Invasion on Spotify, Mixcloud, YouTube, and everywhere dance music is sold, streamed, or enjoyed. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, Bird One reminds you that you are alive, you are beautiful, and you are not alone.